What's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Game Informer's Replay. Today, we're traveling back to 1997, when the world was a better place. Melodies like that, playing all over the place. I'm Andrew Reiner. We've got Kyle Hilliard here.
Hello.
Justin Pierre of Motion City Soundtrack is joining us.
Can you believe it?
No, it's awesome. And you're here for a very special reason. Mm-hmm. And then we have Javy Gwaltney.
Gwaltney,
named by George Lucas, with a chicken on his head.
Wait, what?
You got a chicken on your head.
You got a chicken on your head. It is squatting on your head like you wouldn't believe.
Don't worry about it. He just died a bunch of Metal Gear Solid 5.
But we're playing Monster Rancher. It's kind of like Pokemon. A little sillier, as you could see.
This is
he fell down. That's
I don't know what you're talking about.
He's okay.
Oh, please give me a monster. Oh, all night? What?
I think it was all right. I misread it as all night.
I think
too.
He said, tell me that it's all right.
Give me a monster all night.
It worked.
Long.
I'm a father.
That's how it happens.
I've never played this, so I'm excited about this.
I've played this, but I've never seen the intro.
What about you, Justin? Have you played this?
Nope. There's a. You'd be better asking me what games I have played than what I haven't.
All right, let's put money down. Okay. Raptor versus Rock Thing.
It's a golem, dude.
Rock Thing.
I'm going to go with Raptor just because I like Is it really a raptor?
Ooh.
Oh, no. Oh, it's a raptor dragon.
I think Justin was right.
No, golem.
Nice. Damn it. Dinosaurs always win.
But no, they don't. In fact,
name one situation where dinosaurs have lost than them going
versus
extinct.
The meteorite.
I was going to go.
They have a history of losing that's against giant funny. Rocks.
That's a good point. God damn it. I really screwed this up.
What an intro!
That was really cool. It was very touching.
It was like old-timey.
It started the guy from that Dreamcast game that we super replayed.
We had a dinosaur. We saw a guy fall.
We have a flapping...
Blue Stinger.
Blue Stinger.
Yeah, it looked like the Blue Stinger guy.
Dogs, Bauer. Yeah. Okay, so here we go. So the whole point of this game is you get to create monsters, and to do that, you use different CDs. So we have a big stack of CDs in front of us. We had Justin bring one of his albums from
the
Motion
City
Soundtrack.
The only one I could find, by the way.
What? But it's the best one because it has a dinosaur on the cover.
It does, yeah.
You don't just have stack of your albums at home?
No. I think I have them somewhere, like one of each. Or like I used to go and buy one and then not unwrap it, when it come out. Or like Japanese imports are really cool because they have like extra songs and it's all in, Japanese. But I don't, I have all of them on vinyl, but I didn't think that would work. Today,
no,
with
no, they won't fit in the PlayStation.
But the only one I have like 20 of these.
So Kyle, we're gonna do some voice acting here.
Okay,
starting with you.
Hello, I need you to sign here, please.
We're going with all caps. Yeah, but
that's the name that we always
we
use.
We
is that your maiden name?
That's my maiden name.
Yeah? Okay.
But here you are, butts. Okay, see you later.
Is that's it? That's my character?
I felt like when you started the character, he was English, and then when we came back from it, he was no longer English.
Well, his mother was British, his father was American.
JB, will you be the note?
The note? Sure. Congratulations. This is to certify you as a monster breeder. Please visit Fimba, first week of April. Signed, Fimba.
Stamp.
Of course, that's Simba from The Lion King's cousin, right?
Mm. Yeah. Second cousin removed.
Yeah, of course.
Oh. I'm the girl?
Yeah, I'm the note, man. You made that choice.
You're here to register, aren't you? Please wait.
Don't make her so sexy. Come on. It's just a young girl.
Justin?
Hello, butts.
Oh, that.
Wow, he's a professional voice actor.
Oh, my gosh, it's almost like you record.
Congratulations on acing the breeder's exam. Good luck. You'll be given an assistant.
Holy crap, wow.
Do you know what assistants do?
I do, so we'll just go in. Okay.
All right, then. Now, I'll introduce you to your new assistant. Go get her here.
That was
pronto.
Amazing.
I'm ad-lib
enjoying this.
Butts, this is your assistant, Holly.
Is this a different
This
woman?
Yeah, this is you now, Kyle.
How do you do? My name is Holly.
I'm trying to do what Justin's doing.
Okay.
I have just completed my training to become your assistant. But don't worry. I'm well trained and familiar with the basics of breeding. Trust me.
Where is this accent going?
Please just trust me.
Mm. You'll have to excuse her boldness. Well, go to town and get your first monster together.
God. I already forgot my accent here. Okay.
I know.
Okay, let's go then.
What the hell is happening?
We have to go build a monster. Look, you cast us.
Look who's here! Teska!
Oh.
That's you?
Yeah. Holly, how have you been?
Come on. We're not going any further. That is an old mother and you need to be an old mother.
Ow.
Holly, come on.
Did you just slap your knee so hard that you said ow?
Hey, no. Holly, we got a program here.
I've been great. I've just been assigned to butts.
Where are you now?
There we go.
All right.
But this is my training teacher.
Can you just say trainer?
He has won the 4 major tournaments many times. Win all of the official tournaments, E through S, and you can enter the 4 major ones too. I'm turning into an old woman. So Teska, yeah, he's great.
That was long ago. I'm retired now.
You sound like a goat.
By the way, Butts, did you get your monster yet?
Not yet. Wait, I'm not Butts. Am I just answering for you?
Your first monster is special. Choose wisely. You can get additional unique monsters from your CDs and learn a lot. Good luck, you two.
Thank you.
And remember to take good care of your monster.
Yeah, master.
Bye.
That's ominous. You are a crazy old man.
We must try and be as good as he was.
We really shouldn't. That's a bad lesson to take away from that.
So here we go. Oh, man, the Colosseum.
Nice
ancient
weather.
Rome, I love it.
I'm glad to be assisting a nice person like you.
Well, that is me.
I was a little worried. It is really a pleasure to meet you, Bots.
Stop stealing my voice.
First, let's get you a monster. If you want a basic type, go to the market.
No, we're not going to buy one.
If you want a monster from a CD,
yes.
Go to the shrine.
Oh, I like that.
Ask me anything.
No. Let's go. Okay, so it's 1,000 week one in April. We're going to go to the shrine, and we're going to make... Oh, is this a new guy?
Yep,
that's you. That would be me.
In the shrine, you'll be able to generate a monster from any CD that you may have. Would you like to try?
Yes, I would.
Hell yeah. Okay,
insert another CD in.
What are we doing first, then? Should we do...
Well, I think we should do Overblood.
Okay.
For our community. Yeah. Let's do Overblood.
Overblood is... Justin, to catch you up, Overblood is a very awful PlayStation 1 game that we played all the way through a couple years ago, and it has become a big hit among our readers.
It stars a man without a wiener.
It's very...
I can relate.
It was like that Resident Evil era game. It was insane.
All right.
Let's see what happens, guys. Oh, my God. Here's the big moment. I just got to... Oh, his voice.
Here's the big moment.
I just got to point out, I've played this game more than any other game in my life. This series.
That's
hundreds of hours.
I believe it.
Oh, my God.
But, like, really? Like, you think this is the game you play the most?
It made a monolith.
I mean...
Is that it?
No.
I thought it was like a sheet that would...
No, it's a gelatinous monolith named Monol.
All right, cool.
Mono.
Oh, cool.
I'm trying to think of some sort of like, it's 2001 reference here. Like, what does it sound like? I know it doesn't make any sense, but I think it should sound like hell.
Yeah,
yeah. Like every time you try to make it fight, it's like, I can't let you do that, buddy.
Wow, what a monster! Good luck raising him.
That's a funny looking monster.
Screw you, Holly.
You have to give him a name. What'll it be?
It's going to be Steve.
Steve the monolith?
Yeah, oh yeah, because that's the protagonist from Overblood.
So, we're not going to stick with Steve.
No. Can we throw Steve away?
Whoa!
There's a face in it!
Oh, God. No, that's not okay. That was not okay. Reiner, get rid of this shit.
Can we just produce a bunch of Steves? No,
get out.
Oh, my God. Oh,
Steve doesn't want to go.
But let's make something else real quick.
Can we please get away from the screen? You already have a monster.
Okay.
Can we get rid of it?
Well, let's go and put him on ice.
Yeah, what can I do for you?
We are going to freeze him.
Oh,
you
thank God.
Freeze them?
Yeah, watch this. Ah!
Wait, whoa. You put that, you like, if you don't want them, you
put them on ice.
Them?
We just made him. Yeah.
And then you can sort of re.
Like you can thaw them?
Yeah, yeah, you can thaw them out then.
Okay, all
right. So you put your monsters on ice, preserve them for all time.
How does that affect them if, like, you go, let's say you go centuries without, you know, thawing them? What do you think?
Are they okay?
They might be a little slower, maybe. Like, maybe stamina goes down a little.
What's the recuperation time on this?
Good question.
Is it like in the movie Aliens, like all of those movies where people are just pretty much good after like a few hours? Or is it like in real life where, you know, you come back
where from, you're dead.
Yeah, yeah.
Where your cells immediately like age to your actual age and wilt and die and turn into a skeleton.
Let's take a poll here, guys. What do you think is the better way to trap a monster and keep it? Pokeball or giant ice ball?
Ice ball.
Well, okay. Functionally.
This is Pokemon Master Expert at the GI office, Kyle Hilliard
speaking.
Because,
like, a Pokeball, you just throw at them and you're, like, you're done. Mm-hmm. But, like, ice, do you have to, like, trick them into a refrigerator or something?
Wait, hold on a second. Like, do you, like let's say you're really outside and, like, how big are these Pokeballs that you have? Do they expand and...
They're very small. They're about the size of your fist.
But how does that collect... The beast, like, how big is the beast? Is the beast even smaller?
You're overthinking it. Yeah. You're way overthinking it.
But then why do you need to think about a refrigeration, like, unit for ice if you don't need to think about a
Pokeball?
He's got you there.
Because Pokeball is technology, and ice is an element.
Refrigerator is not an element, by the way.
Okay. Oh, so what disc should we do next? you've trapped me, Justin.
It wasn't my intention. I was trying to get down to the science of it.
No, these are excellent questions. I don't know. How does it work here? You just like press a button and they're frozen, I guess. I still like the Pokeball.
Butts is actually carrying around a freeze ray. Yeah. Like, that's what's going
on. That's
see, they didn't explain that in the.
Yeah, that must be in the booklet.
Yeah.
All right, here's the big moment.
What did you put in?
Crash Bandicoot.
Oh, okay.
Ooh. You guys were deep in conversation. We started playing.
Really into this Pokeball chat.
Come on,
another monolith.
It's just going to be Crash.
Is there, like, if you do this, are there, like, consistent ones? Like, you kind of see, like, oh, this is just the generic one that comes?
Yeah, there's not, like, hundreds of them. Wow, we got a raptor!
Hey, it's our bud from the intro.
Oh. And he's got a little scaly.
He's messed up.
And it's glowing like
he's the run of the litter.
Tetsuo's brain scanner from Akira.
Dino.
What an interesting, unique name.
Okay, you know what? This would have been perfect for your CD.
That's true.
Because that's on the cover. Let's do that one next. We're going to put him on ice.
Freeze that sucker.
That's even crueler.
What?
Than putting the monolith on ice.
That's a
unique monolith
monster.
With a face.
I like the monolith.
A one-of-a-kind thing? This is just a standard raptor.
No,
who cares?
I mean, it's cruel freezing him. Let's just call him Icicle.
Can you call him Dino?
Oh, good. Yes,
I'm poop.
I'm 12.
This show is for fucking children, Reiner.
I know. Okay, let's...
But your language is not.
Again, Freaks. You're overthinking it, Justin.
Okay, watch. This is the big moment.
Yeah. He's like...
Suck it, you little bastard.
I see. He did a little jump for joy there.
He tried to get out. Yeah. He tried to get out of the fridge and he failed.
He's like, oh, wait, what's that?
Oh, man.
Gosh.
Okay, this is exciting. So which album is this specifically?
This one's called My Dinosaur Life, which is, let's see, when did it come out? 2010?
2010, okay.
Yeah, it's the only CD, it was the only album that was on Columbia as opposed to Epitaph.
Gotcha.
Oh, here's the big moment.
All right, let's do it. What's it gonna be?
What is it?
Is that
It's a Transformer?
Oh, it's...
Wow, that's a rare beast! That is a really good monster.
Yeah, all right, cool.
What is it?
Iceman. He's a tiger sub, even. Whoa. Okay, we got to rock this guy. So, I would sit in front of my TV in my console, PlayStation 1, putting CDs in for hours on end. That's all I would do. What are we going to name this guy?
Um, Randall.
Oh man, you had me up on F.
I know. I was trying to think of a name. Nothing jumped out.
I was going
to
say, name him after the album.
But Rambo cool. Or Randall?
Randall.
Randall.
Okay. No, that's Randall. That's nice. You're trying to give him a nice life,
buddy. That's not how you spell Randall.
That was kind of like handle.
Have you ever seen the name Randall in your life?
Is it R-A-N-D-A-L-L?
Your name starts with R.
I think I did John Randall.
You should be an expert on names
with R's. Okay, so that's his last name, Randall.
Oh, and this, we can freeze this guy too?
We could.
But he's an ice tiger.
I want to see what it's like to freeze the Iceman.
So you must have two frozen parents. Your new child has their traits. Try different combinations. So you can do that. We're not going to do that though.
Freeze the Iceman.
Okay, I want to get out of here. And let's go to the ranch, guys.
Oh, we're going to fight with Randall?
We're going to train Randall.
Oh, we're going to train. Okay.
That Coliseum in the background comes later.
I am irrationally angry at you for spelling Randall like that.
Why? What would you do?
I'd spell it correctly, like a human being.
Like an EO?
You are not allowed to complain about weird spelling of
names.
Yes,
I am. I'm an expert.
Okay, what is this? Is it A-L?
It's R-A-N-D-A-L.
L-E. Okay.
No, it's not.
It John Randall.
It's not
R A N D L E.
John Randall.
Okay, so what should we get? What should we give him to eat?
It's an ice monster. I'm gonna go with.
He's near water, right?
Yeah,
fish.
But he's probably never had a potato.
I want to give him a potato because that makes no sense.
Yeah,
give him a potato. There it goes.
Okay.
Oh, look at him.
He likes the potato.
So cute.
You did good, Justin.
I am so sorry.
Okay,
stuck with that name, Randall.
So it goes Randall. It goes week to week. You have a schedule. You can work, train, battle.
Okay.
So we'll do a little work. You have all these different activities.
So is this kind of like? Is it like a Tamagotchi?
Yeah. Yeah. In a way.
Okay.
Weird. But you are training. You're leveling them up. So you can see power, intelligence, defense, speed, intelligence. So you get some that will hurt them, but give you double gains.
We're leveling him up by making him do chores.
Yeah. And we're giving him power because he's a big guy.
So you're basically getting...
There he goes!
he's our farm boy.
Well, that's cool. Yeah. So they have like 2D versions of all the monsters too?
That's a lot of work.
Is it? And then you just fight them? Like, is there like a story or an RPG?
There is fighting. So you'll see. That's where the real game comes in here. He's not going to be very smart, okay, guys? Or we're just all...
Well, he doesn't even know how to spell Randall, so...
You don't know. He could be like the ape from Overwatch. What's his name? Winston? He could be super smart. You don't know that.
Oh, I think he blew it. Yeah, he blew it.
What happened?
He fell asleep.
What were you trying to get him to do?
Guard. And he wasn't awake.
Why'd you
and
punish
he's pissed
him?
Now.
Randall.
Oh, well, okay. He feels sorry. Some monsters are very defiant. This game is so
I think Randall
good.
Randall has low self-esteem, guys. I think we need to boost his self-esteem. Is there a way to
good
do
point.
That?
Can we hug Randall?
He's really cold.
Oh. Who is it? Whose turn is it?
Well, let's get Justin. Okay. Justin does the best. He should do
may
everybody.
May I help you?
Oh, see. Can I, what was my voice for her? Kind of British, right? can I get some info on the training courses?
Well, may I have your name and the breeder's name as well, please?
My name is Holly. The breeder is Butts.
Ooh. That's a good name. This is your first visit here, right? We provide training services for a fee. Training is 4 weeks. Your monster is away for that time.
Are you okay?
For safety, he trains only appropriate courses.
I'm dialing 911. I don't like this lady.
Any questions?
I don't think so. Please don't cry.
Please select one.
Sorry, I will select one. It's okay.
Okay, guys. So we got Alta Vista.
Isn't that like an old
Tonga.
Search engine?
So you can see, again, you're getting different things, but he gets very fatigued. This one has, what do you call that?
Oh, a theme park with it. The corner.
Which one should we do?
Oh, I like the theme park. I think you should ride on something.
Theme park. Yeah, because we gotta work on that self-esteem.
Yeah.
Get up there.
So
there
if we can
go.
Conquer something like the roller coaster. Oh, it costs 2000G, period. Is that okay?
No, because we can't afford it.
See you in 4 weeks.
Wait,
training is over.
We spent $10 on a potato.
Oh, well, I thought
there he goes.
Just storms
there.
Over there.
See ya.
Hope I don't melt in this ocean.
Oh, he blew it.
Okay, wait. Did he just, like, we spent $4,000?
We had to get him.
To send him to a theme park?
He's just drowning in water.
And
yeah.
He died on the way there?
He's terrible.
Money well spent.
Gosh.
He's not doing well, guys.
he's in bad shape right now.
No. Oh.
Yeah! Randall!
Way to go,
good, buddy.
Good job, Randall. Wait.
Come on.
Yeah.
I thought we sent him to a theme park, but he's swimming?
This is what he likes to do, man.
Okay.
He's a water beast.
Randall is back.
Randall is back from training, but he wasn't successful. Punish him?
Don't punish him.
No, he needs selfish. Well, this is tough.
Look, man.
What type of punishments can you do?
What path are we going down? Are we renegade?
Do Paragon, man.
I don't want to, like, hurt him, but I also want him to learn. But I would say if punishment is, like, a violent act, then no.
Does he look sorry to you?
Yes, he looks
sad. Oh, he looks super sad and sorry. I think we need to build him up.
Okay.
We need to start a little lower.
He gave you music.
Yeah?
Oh.
Randall seems to be relieved.
He's blown up.
What? We didn't punish him.
We did too much. Oh, no. Okay, you know what?
He needs to
Randall,
rest.
Randall, buddy. Take a break. Although you did that when you were on guard duty, you little bastard.
Let the resentment against your bad name fester.
So there's three of these games, by the way. They made two sequels, and they're all fantastic.
Are they all disc like this?
Yes.
What's your favorite of the three? Do you have?
I think two. Two or three. But this is the first one, and they just get better as they go.
It's kind of like the Evil Dead series, right?
Right.
Okay.
Army of Darkness. I love the new show, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
I want to watch that so bad.
It is. I have it on Blu-ray. I'll bring it in for you.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I think it's time to... Guys...
Let's do
battle?
It.
I guess.
Tell me there's a rap battle.
Oh, that's right. We gotta. So week two, we can enter this one. So we gotta train a little more, and then we can go in.
Okay.
So we're right here.
Sure.
So we'll do a little more work. Let's have him go into the forest.
Ooh. Shake that tree, Randall.
Oh, that's God. How does that build up speed?
I'm getting Shenmue 2 flashbacks. You punch a tree in that game.
Yeah, you do.
Okay.
That's good.
I mean, I trust you.
All right, guys. We were cheap on him last time.
No, give him a meat.
Give him the good stuff.
A meat.
There you go. Here you go, Randall.
Give him this one. An official tournament comes up at the end of this month. Check on Randall.
Up.
Randall is very tired.
This beast, I tell you, he just doesn't get it.
So we gotta make him rest again?
I guess look at him. He's made for sleeping.
Can we just have him be like a doorstop?
He's like a frosty Snorlax.
All right. Let's see. Is it time? Let's do it.
Like a Obama Snow?
I don't know what that
Commenters
is.
Commenters.
Oh, okay. This will be good. So he might lash out on me in the battle and do his own thing.
Ooh. Randall's his own man.
Okay, here we go. This could go terribly. We might lose Randall.
Wait, what?
I hope you're not attached to Randall.
I'm very attached to Randall.
Are
you saying like gone for good or just like on hiatus?
This is to the death.
This is to the death?
Kyle, this is you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the battle.
I'm a very dull announcer.
Rambar, a red raptor. See?
Rambar. Wait, that probably means he's fire.
Try to expend all of Randall's will during fights by using it wisely throughout the bout.
I feel like Randall and Lambar sounds like a good TV show.
Randall and Lambar. Yeah. I still like John Randall.
John
I want to
Randall.
See the John Randall. Okay. He just goes out and lives in the forest.
It punches trees.
That's right. Okay.
Punches trees.
I'm glad I looked at that because you got to use the shoulder buttons to move, which is very strange.
So it's not really turn-based like you're actually going to be doing
it's
this.
Active battle, yeah.
Oh, gosh.
You got this.
Oh. Guys,
hit hard and fast like a butterfly.
Cross those fingers.
Please don't get Randall killed. It's bad enough you gave him that name.
I mean, Justin worked hard on that Motion City soundtrack album to produce Randall.
Randall. Yeah.
So
this is the culmination of that album. How does that feel?
I thought you saw it.
What?
Is he wearing a bandana? Is that other one wearing a bandana?
Maybe flowers.
Whoa, it's tripping me out.
Oh, numbers.
Boy.
Numbers.
So,
I like his
Randall's
power.
Got a little more power, right?
And defense.
All right, do it.
Not as much skill. He's more intelligent. What?
This.
Oh yeah, it's a dumb dinosaur, man.
Okay, so you can see we got brow hit, belly claw, Belly claw.
Oh,
nice
no.
Nice move, kid. He's so I'm going to get in. And so the range is based on where that little red cursor is. That's the move I can do.
Okay. That stupid dinosaur.
So there he goes.
Oh, we're going to get our asses move. Kicked by Barney.
No, we got this, guys. We got this.
This is exciting.
We got it. I'm trying to get away, but this guy is crowding me. Like
Reiner, I think this might be your quadrilateral cowboy.
No, this series was here. It got sequels.
Is there a sequel
coming to your game?
Maybe.
No.
What was I going to say? I already forgot.
Guys, that was a nice kick, but he missed. I mean, this is just like UFC, right? Same intensity.
Exactly.
Do you think you...
Wow.
The
data it's pulling to produce like the monsters, like could you like burn discs to kind of you could like figure out what it was and then burn the
discs? No. So that last hit right there.
But he didn't die.
No, he's okay.
No. Did he fall apart?
Guys, it's okay. It's okay.
You said it was to the death.
It's okay. So you could see here it's a tournament bracket kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So now we're going to go against this boar.
That's like bull. A dog.
That is straight up a Pokemon. Like, that looks just like the goat Pokemon.
Okay. I apologize for my skills there. I should have done kick sooner.
What are you thinking?
Oh, that's
another dinosaur.
Just like a furry triceratops.
Yeah.
Justin trusted you to train this creature, tops. And you're just, like, failing.
My heart is heavy.
We can do this.
My eyes are weepy.
Are those lyrics of one of your songs?
Yeah, that's something I'm working on.
Okay, as we're doing this, I have questions for you, Justin. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
When you guys go on tour, you've gone to Australia, all over the place.
Mm-hmm. And I did play Pokemon Go.
Good.
In all those places, and I got one. It was my wife's account. Yes, I got that one, but I did not get the one in England.
Mr. Mime?
Yeah, I did not. But I guess our tour manager at the time made the bus driver stop at 2:30 or 3 in the morning, and he ran out to a park and got one. So,
nice.
They were obsessed, and I didn't understand it at all, but my wife had an account. She's a few years younger than me, and when I went over there, I played it because I had a lot of downtime.
Yeah.
And I tried to get her things, but I literally haven't played it since I came
back. Nice.
Come on. 9 seconds. Sorry, Justin. Well,
you did the right thing, Justin. The Genghis... I've played the crap out of the game, Reiner and I, and we do not have Genghis Khans because we haven't been...
Oh.
No! I did it again. I blew it again. Last second bite to the crotch.
You blew it, man.
Every time.
You blew it, man.
It's the story of my life. While you're on tour, what is gaming like? Do you guys bring consoles, or is it just handheld stuff, mostly phone?
It depends. We used to. I actually got into the phone stuff later, like in the last year or two, and I'm really into like the weird... Here, I should look at it.
Wait, we won that.
How did you win that?
Percentage-wise. We had more percentage.
Good job.
The games that I liked, and let me see, The Room, the first three.
Yeah. Those are quality stuff. Yep.
I liked Monuments. That was fun.
Another dinosaur?
Monuments, good.
Yellow one.
The Silent Age. I've only played the three one. It's weird. It's just a trippy, weird kind of thing where you go back and forth from two different times, like into the future 30 years and then back, and you have to bring things with you to get out of situations. It's really trippy and weird. I tried to play Lumino City. I got a little lost.
I reviewed that game, actually.
But I liked it. It's
very pretty.
Yeah, yeah.
Reiner, like, what are you even doing here?
I'm tickling a dinosaur.
Like,
you saw it. That was the...
I don't think that was tickling.
Justin, make sure you download 10 million.
Here, I should be writing this down, right?
And, 10 million. And You Must Build a Boat.
Build a Boat.
Those are
good.
My favorite mobile games.
Yeah, let me see. 10 million.
Yeah.
And You Must Build a Boat.
Yes.
Oh man, this record.
We
got a tickle. We got a good tickle.
Good too.
This could go down to the death, guys.
Well, was there another one?
The Go games, Hitman Go, Lord.
We got it.
Go.
We got it.
Did you murder him?
Oh,
it
was like all the. Okay.
Oh, we totally did.
You murdered a dinosaur, you monster.
And we taunted it afterwards.
I tried to play like a Fallout game, but it was just too consuming.
Fallout Shelter.
Yeah, I just kind of like I grew to hate it. It became a job.
All right, it comes down to this: if we win this battle,
we go into the rap battle.
Yes. Against Rhaegar. That's a nice name.
Crab battle.
The perfectly spelled John Randall beast.
Whatever. Newgrounds fans.
Versus Rhaegar.
Are you prepared for a rap battle, Justin?
Performing one, no. Viewing one, always.
A good answer.
Yeah.
What? Shoot.
Oh, there's one more game. I just wanted to bring up that I love it, and it's terrifying and weird and so lo-fi but awesome. Her Story.
Oh yeah.
I'm stuck. But
did you try typing in a bunch of words?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I think I've gone through everything, but there's like so many more.
Yeah.
Like I haven't figured it out yet.
The creator of that game's so interesting. I've talked to him a couple of times. Sam Barlow.
Yeah.
He's out there. He used to work on Silent Hill. Like when they started like doing American versions of Silent Hill. He is an interesting fellow.
But yeah, that game is, I love everything about it.
Yeah, it's good.
And the actress is amazing.
Oh yeah, she's great. I hope to see her in like anything. Like not even necessarily game stuff. Movies, just like put her in something, man.
So the bottom is stamina, so I can't do anything because I was too aggressive. But now, get the tickle in. Oh, he missed.
Reiner, is this how you used to pick fights when you were younger? You would like tickle people? Is that like how you would conduct yourself in a barroom brawl?
No, I'd knock them the hell out.
By tickling them?
No, with a fist to their face. Like, violent.
He has
I know how to fight.
I've never been in a fight.
Really?
And I hope to never be in one.
JV?
I've been in like 4 fights in my life.
Justin, it's time to fight.
Time to fight?
Okay. All right.
We lost the tournament, by the way.
Oh,
that's okay. We're talking about fighting.
Tickling and bubble games. Oh, God. Why does his head fall out?
A lot like J.J. Abrams' Lost logo. Yeah.
I was waiting for that.
Yeah.
But we won some money.
Here's the prize money. Oh.
We did not get any fame because...
No, I can't wait to see Randall's fame.
Oh, we got 6. Okay, yes, good. He's a good boy. Let's make one more monster, just see what happens, and then let's take a look at another game.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, man. What do you guys think? Seriously.
I think it's very cool.
Think back to 97. JV, you're obviously thinking today, comparing it to all the great hits. I don't know what the hell you're doing.
I mean, I played this.
What?
Yeah, I played this.
Yeah, he said that at the beginning.
Yeah,
Want to encourage him? No.
I was 8 years old when this came out.
I think I was too interested in drinking and other thing, like just bad, horrible human behavior.
Being an adult.
List amounts.
Learning to be an adult.
Specific examples, please.
Specific examples. I'm trying to remember. I did.
Well, not fighting.
Okay.
So we know it's not fighting.
You guys, no fighting. Oh, wait. We're
putting an ice beast on ice. Will this work?
It's about time.
Anybody know science?
I've met science.
I guess you'd have to. The ice would have to be.
Oh,
he's cold. Yeah.
Fetal position.
Oh, it's like he's a fetus in ice.
So we grab. We have a bunch of discs still. Like we have. We have. What is it?
I want to put Clock Tower.
Tecmo's Deception.
Tecmo's Deception is another Tecmo game that will produce a rare monster.
Well, let's do that.
Should we do that one? I also grabbed like a Saturn game too, because apparently Saturn games work. So
let's see what happens.
Any disc. But not DVDs, I guess. I guess it has to be a CD-ROM, right?
I mean, DVDs weren't around.
Yeah, it didn't exist back then.
Can you imagine like trying to stuff a laser disc in there?
You could break it in half, I guess.
Feed it bit by bit.
That's how CD players work, right?
Give us something that's not a dinosaur.
There was a time, because we released one of the first things we did in Motion City was we had a mini CD that just had a single on
it. Yeah, I remember those.
Because I remember you had to put it at a time, you had to put it in the middle of a tray.
Yep. So the old PlayStation, you could do that.
But with this, can you?
No, that would break your system.
Okay. It'll kill it.
All right. So it's like too old of technology.
Yeah. Yep. It's basically like feeding your console poison, is what you would be doing.
So basically, if you have anything.
Cyanide pill. Yeah.
All right. Let's see what happens.
Those were like GameCube disc sized, I think. Those were like singles, right? I had a couple of those.
Yeah, they always came packaged with like CDs and DVDs and stuff.
All right, here we go. Oh, it's a very rare one.
All right.
Yeah, so this
Wait, what did it just say?
Did we skip it?
I skipped the text. I think it said it was too rare.
What?
You must go before.
I think you got to level up. Yeah.
Oh, that's a bunch of garbage.
All right, let's stick Clock Tower in there.
Well, let's see. Clock Tower sounds good to me. We also have a Saturn game.
Y'all, it's Clock Tower.
All right, I don't have any.
So describe
love for
this Clock Tower.
It is a trashy survival horror game.
Like you can see on the cover, it's like a dude with giant scissors. chopping off heads, presumably.
Like, it is like one of the worst villains in any horror thing ever. It's so cheesy and glorious.
Cheesy and glorious.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I'm going to describe tonight's meal that I'm making for my family.
What is that going to be?
I don't know if this is actually cheesy.
Manicotti?
No, I make dinner. This is what I do now. I make dinner every day. But I cheat because I use like a slow cooker. So I just kind of put all the shit in there in the morning. And then it's like surprise food at the end of the day.
Is your next album going to be about food?
I think, I mean, if you want to like read deeply into all of the albums that have existed, most, I'd say like 82% of them are about food.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like Weird Al really.
All right. Here's the big moment. And Justin, you and I are throwing around some ideas for something we're working on.
Can we talk about it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's talk about it.
We're going to do a one-man show, the two of us.
What?
I feel like I've seen this before.
But that was us reacting to your announcement of the one-man show.
Okay. Yeah. Sorry. Maybe we should come up with a different idea.
Yeah.
Maybe something in the realm of music.
Can we throw it back?
All right, we gotta make one more.
Yeah. And plus, we gotta hear about.
But
the,
anyway, keep talking. Yeah.
Reject.
His name's
Reject.
Music, right? Music.
We're gonna be doing music.
Maybe
about video games.
Music about video games.
But in a way you haven't seen before.
Well, or heard, hopefully.
Yes.
But also seen.
I feel like Justin's learning these details at the same time we are.
I won't say. You go ahead and say what it is.
Well, I don't know if I like how much. I don't like to talk.
We don't
want to
give away the whole idea.
Yeah, and I don't want to.
We
like,
could
talk
say
about
what
things.
Game.
Well, I think what like we've been talking, and like one of my favorite games, the game that got me back into gaming after like the last game I really played was in like the late 90s. It was the Zelda Ocarina of Time. That was like the last game. And then I just kind of like from that moment was when I really started playing music a lot, and I just didn't have time for anything else. And then I just stopped playing video games. And then when the first BioShock game came out, I was watching one of the guys who was working for us. He would just like play it all night. And I just was obsessed with it. I was like, this
what
is amazing.
What the hell is this?
Yeah, it's one of those Triceratops things.
Why does
it looks like the, I was going to say it reminds me of the monster in Ghostbusters, kind of.
Oh, Gozer.
Oh, it does.
Yeah, it's totally Gozer.
I like
him. Look at him dance.
Like, yeah, a little more cheerful.
Yeah, I like him.
So BioShock pulled you back into gaming.
Yeah.
Although, to be fair, Ocarina of Time is a good one to like drop the mic on and be like, done.
I mean,
yep,
we've
apexed.
That, at the time, it was like mind-blowing.
I love that game.
Yeah, probably still is.
Yeah, I had a similar thing where I quit games right before I went to college just for like 3 or 4 years and didn't play them. Mm-hmm. I think it's pretty funny. I dropped out with Jade Empire. Like, I finished that. I was like, that's really good. And then Mass Effect 2 came out. And I was like, okay, yeah, I'll try this. And then I was all in again. Mm-hmm. It's so good.
But so BioShock is a factor of what you and Reiner are working on.
Yes. Yeah, we were just talking about games, and I'm like, I love this game, but it's just such a whole, like, it's just got everything that I like, from like the film noir kind of aspect to what is this? He's just walking.
He blew it. Supposedly he was supposed to do something.
No, don't punish him. No, Reiner.
He's got red horns. He's from hell. He's,
Reiner,
he's
why
cool
are you such a garbage person?
Uh-oh.
But
we're not putting him in anything. So that is Monster Rancher. We'll continue the conversation, but that is Monster Rancher. Mm. Let's take a quick commercial break and play something else.
Something's coming up the plumb in Puerto Luigi's in a bind. Giant turtles out to get him. Creepy crabs are right behind. Spider flies, cheaper shites, they're all coming out the pipes.
Mario, where are you?
It's Atari Mario Brothers with Mario from Donkey Kong, his brother Luigi, and lots of crazy creatures. And it's twice the fun when two play at once, because you need all the help you can get.
Mario, where are you?
Mario Brothers, new from Atari.
All right, Justin, since you are a rock star, we're playing a rock star game called Guitaro Man.
Well, it's not made by Rockstar, the people who make Grand Theft Auto. Don't get confused. It's a game about playing guitar.
Every time you say the title, do you have to sing it?
Yes. Well, how would you sing it?
Exactly the way that you sang it.
Really?
Yeah. Guitar on the
All right, Kyle, you have to do it.
You might even want to do a meow. Do a little like that.
Like the Trey Parker. Yeah.
Meow. Guitaru meow.
Yeah.
Now you're a guitaru meow.
Guitaru man.
There you go, JV.
Shut up, JV.
So this is a sequel to the... Or no, this was...
Whoa.
There was only one of these.
Wow.
There's only one of these. It was well received. They actually brought it back
to PSP.
Yes.
Right? Okay.
Are we sure this isn't actually like Katamari or something? Because this is trippy.
It's not, man. You play guitar. It's a good time.
You roll over crowds.
No.
I wish I could hear the music a little more.
There you go.
Oh, there we
Ask
go.
And you shall.
Oh, wow. That was wild.
Yeah, Wade's that chick like that. He's got my hair.
Basically, our project's going to sound just like this, right?
Yeah, this is it. I think...
So you guys are just covering...
I mean, it's kind of bumming me
us.
Out.
That's us when we play.
It's kind of bumming me out how much it sounds like what we've been doing. But, you know, we might have to tweak it a little bit. Oh, wow. The dreams have abandoned...
Those are our lyrics, too.
I have other dreams I haven't given up on. They still shine bright. They still light my way.
Also, rapture.
Donuts. And girls.
I mean, this is my pretty legit dream, guys.
Put the two together and look out.
So this is a game I've never played, but feel like I should have played because I like quirky rhythm games.
I think this is Game Informer editor Matthew Cotto, one of his favorite games of all time.
Oh, really? Okay.
Wow, really?
I might be making that up.
I don't know. Just Cotto seems very subdued.
Whoa. Man, dinosaurs everywhere in this replay. Kick ass.
I love this so far.
Oh, the beans? Did you guys see that The Beans poster? Playing off Abbey Road. It's good stuff.
I really got to go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
You won. Khan's even pecking on you again. You're really, like, totally useless, aren't you?
Oh, shut up, Puma.
But you won. There's something you can do about it, I think. Come on. Let's go.
What is this?
Shot. It's about overcoming bullies, obviously.
And a talking dog.
There you go. What'd you guys think?
Can I just play this for the
That's
rest
the game?
Of the
That's it.
And then you just have different reactions, like does
okay,
he drop
here
the
we
tennis
go.
Racket?
I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. It's rhythmic based.
Yeah. So you
That's
might not
kanji.
You might have to concentrate. Oh, I like that.
Where's cool. Papa the Rapa?
I'm sorry, can you say that name again?
Yeah.
Papa the Rapa? Is that not right?
No.
No.
Sure, Papa the Rapa. It's time to leave.
Okay.
Jeez.
Parappa the Rapper.
On.
I didn't play it.
You also, but you've read the title.
So that doesn't mean I know how to pronounce it.
Fair point.
Is this one of those games that you're supposed to like get you to exercise while you play them?
No, it's just...
Okay.
This is me rotating my head.
Okay.
I am digging this like little beat here, though.
It's nice.
Okay, so I got to keep... See, I keep my head here.
Dogs can do it.
Off center. Center.
Okay, give it a whirl. Look carefully.
Everybody has an instrument but me.
Oh, God.
I got this, guys.
Also, there's definitely like no accordion in what we're hearing. I don't know. You have a better ear for that kind of stuff than I do, I'm sure, Justin. I am not hearing cymbals. No, I am hearing cymbals crash. But I am not hearing any accordion.
I'm hearing like flashbacks of like early 80s rap music. Or like early Fresh Prince.
My name's Guitar Man and I'm here to
DJ
say
Jazzy Jeff, yeah.
I can play a tennis racket in a cool way.
Hey, that's pretty good.
I'm ready for the rap battle. The second Justin brought it up, I've been,
you've been prepping.
There you go.
Oh, man. So this is...
If it goes off 4-4, I'm in trouble.
There we
so
go.
So this is like, what's the game, the music where you play all the songs?
Or Rock Band?
Rock Band, yeah.
Yeah, basically like a, what, an earlier version of
yeah,
that?
Yeah, precursor to Rock Band.
Or kids version?
Guitar Hero.
This is so much cooler than all of those things.
Was Motion City's probably in Rock Band, right?
I don't think we're in any of it.
Yeah?
But I don't know. But I'm going to go with no.
Oh, okay.
Oh, man. What's that thing
I
the guy
really
from Muse has on his guitar?
The string?
Chaos pad?
Oh. Chaos
pad. Yeah, that reminds me of like some sort of Moog. Like.
Is anyone else thinking of intestines looking at this?
I am now.
I like this.
I think more like arteries.
Yeah.
Is what I'm thinking of.
This game is so much fun.
It looks pretty easy.
Kyle, do you want to play?
I'd be up for it.
Here.
Oh, wait. Oh, we're going to pass
last words. No, I mean, you just said that, and, you know, screw you, Kyle. I made that look good.
I know.
I really did.
It was just a tutorial. I wasn't trying. I was making a joke about the tutorial.
No, good luck, Kyle.
Oh, now, oh, of course, now I'm the one who has to fight.
You just have a tennis racket. Don't worry. It's going to be okay.
Just swap things away. All right. Got it.
Oh, yeah, because he turns into Gitaru Man. All right.
Got it, talking dog. What button do I press? X or circle?
Circle.
Circle? Okay.
Yeah. Lay down the hottest riffs.
Okay, good.
Riffs are too hot.
Okay.
Oh, I got hit.
Oh, boy, you're okay, done. Okay. This is like Shenmue all over.
Oh, God.
Quick time events.
Quick time events are the best. That's why no one ever criticizes David Cage games.
It's never happened.
Ever. Or Telltale games.
No, I mean, just flawless.
They're perfect.
All right. I'm ready to concentrate.
Here we go.
A three. A four.
Boom. That a boy.
Yeah, Kyle's doing fine. See?
Double fine.
Is this changing your world of music, Justin?
Yeah, I'm learning some stuff. I mean, it's like...
Kyle, you're so good at this.
Thank you,
I'm hearing this sort of like... DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince beat, but those little like xylophone things, there was like a little bit of like Esquivel, like something loungy coming in, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I hear what you're saying, yeah.
Like I feel like there's some sort of...
just need a glass of wine.
It's like the opening credits of I Dream of Jeannie or something.
Yeah.
I don't like our dog.
Everybody's really feeling it, though. Kinda...
Well, that guy seems kind of mad. Oh, there's more to this? Oh, jeez. I want to at least play a real song.
We're going to get there. We're going to get
just
there.
The intro. Like,
yeah, this is just teaching me how to play.
Tutorial.
What do you think, JD?
I want to play this more.
I think it's on PSP, which means it might be on Vita. Maybe.
What's a Vita?
It's the PSP Evita? Successor.
I know it's a movie with Madonna.
Oh, is it really?
Oh, you mean that corpse that Sony buried?
JV, that's enough. That's enough of your negativity. Get out of here.
All right. Bye.
Oh my gosh. He's done. All right.
Oh, you're missing the great music. Justin's like, I'll see ya.
Sorry I had to do that, Justin.
Would now be a good time to hand out presents now that there's one presents. Less person?
Yeah, I wanted to get rid of him.
Oh, crap.
Oh, Kyle. Hilliard.
Well,
showing
more for Wade.
Oh, my gosh.
I brought some Kit Kats from Japan.
Wow.
Oh, sweet.
So they're actual chocolate. And
let me hold
like
one of those up to the camera
plastic,
here.
I believe. But
look
we've
at
got,
this.
We've got green tea Kit Kats. They're better than they sound. And then those are Sakura, which I think is, it's like the cherry blossom.
Ah, okay.
Which is, I don't know if they sell, no, I think they sell them whenever, but there's like a week in Japan or like 2 weeks where they do all sorts of cherry blossom stuff. And like at Starbucks, you can only get this one drink during that, that time period.
It's like
and
pumpkin
stuff.
Spice for us here, right?
Yeah. And so I just, whenever I go to Japan, I stock up on Kit Kats and I'm trying not to eat sugar and it's Halloween. So I figured I'd bring candy.
Whoa, awesome. Well, thank you. We'll dig into those as soon as the show's done here.
Yeah, maybe
got a few minutes left.
Remember that time we picked out Javy? That was funny.
Oh, screw that guy. Sorry, everybody had to see that, but I mean, it was too much, right?
Yeah,
he was attacking the Vita, and then you brought up a Madonna movie, and he instantly attacked that.
I know. It's just like what? No respect.
And the chicken hat at the beginning, like what was that?
Clearly, he has issues.
I think we're going to get to a song, Kyle.
Do we get to do a real song?
So does he turn into Gitaru Man? I'm sorry, Gitaru Man! Does he turn into that before the battle or after the battle?
I think we're going to see his evolution right here.
Oh, wow.
Chop you. Uh-oh.
Well, that's messed up.
No,
you're just hanging out at home pretending to play a... tennis racket?
And some floaty goat demon comes down and tells you they're going to chop you in half.
So is this kind of like that Ralph Macchio movie of him versus taking on the devil.
Oh, you mean Crossroads?
Yeah.
Where Steve Vai plays the guitar part for the devil?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is pretty much the same thing.
I did exactly not know that movie existed. That's amazing.
It's been viewed by me many, many times.
Here we go.
Okay. Whoa.
So the dog had the power.
Okay, so now I'm Guitaru Man.
And you've got Robo Dog.
Oh, here we go. Oh,
wow. I love the
squealing.
Yeah. That's so good.
I like that this is just happening in my bedroom.
I know. I wonder where the parents are and what they're thinking. Or if this is like before they come home from work.
Kids upstairs really rocking out.
Wow, wow, wow. Yeah, that's
right. I love that tone.
Yeah.
Oh, my desk chair is just spinning. Like, things are getting out of hand here.
For anybody who's watching this who has never been to Japan, this is pretty much what it's like 24/7.
Okay. But more kick-ass.
This is what your shows are like?
No, this is just like walking around the street, especially like in Tokyo. It's exactly like this.
I believe you.
Yeah.
Another question I want to know the answer to as a musician. What is the best show you played? What was the most fun you had on stage?
I mean, let's see. Fun. It's tough. I do feel like the last show that we played, knowing it was going to be our last show in Chicago at the Metro, we played for almost 2.5 hours.
Wow.
We pulled some, like, you know, U2 shit. and we came up for like several encores, but it was just sort of like our last thing, and we played a lot of songs we hadn't played in a while. Probably shouldn't have played some of them because we were a little rusty. But it was just so much fun, and like knowing that that was it, I was nervous, but I could also let go a bit more. So that's definitely like, I don't know, it was this moment. But other than that, I feel like we've had a lot of good, you know, shows, and there was one in Chicago many Warp tours ago, we always talk about it, where we weren't, like, you know, we were kind of known, but I think Fall Out Boy was closing the night, like, on the main stage, and we were on, like, a side stage, and for some reason, we were playing after them, so, like, nobody was going to come.
Right.
You know? And suddenly, like, I don't know if it was the weather, I don't know what was going on, but it was packed, and then I remember looking behind me, and all of the people on the tour were watching us, too, and it was just like this crazy thing. It was a great show, and it was just a weird, wonderful moment. That one stands out. And then also on this last tour that we were on, we played New Jersey, Sayreville, every time that we played there, it's been pretty great. And this last time was even greater. So I don't know. I mean, there's been a lot of shows. It's just kind of weird.
It sounds like
I tend to go on performance. Like, if we do well and the energy is good, that's usually, you know, a lot of times the energy is good, but I'm having a shit show,
right?
And so it's hard for me to like love it, but or if the crowds are weird, which never really happens unless you're playing a college show or
in your bedroom,
Japan. But like, it's only weird in Japan because they're so damn respectful.
Sure.
Like, you're done with the song, they clap for about 2 seconds, really crazy, like, and then it's just silent, and then they just wait because they're just like, all right, we're ready, you know. So it's
next
weird
song,
but yeah.
So I asked that question as a setup for my real question.
Okay.
Which is, what is the worst show? I really want to know. What is the worst show you played?
Tripping
Icarus, my band played one in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Mm-hmm. This little dive bar that our bass player Chris Cluey set up with some guy he met, I don't know. There was no one there except the bartender. We're playing like on the side of the bar. It was the worst thing ever. Like, absolutely the worst thing. A biggest waste of our time. Took us forever to get out there. And then we just drove back like at 3 a.m. Like, this was not worth it.
I've got
made like 20 bucks.
That's more than I've made at some. I mean, there's different types of shows. There was one show where I had a nervous breakdown / meltdown. I used to be really bad whenever I'd screw up. I couldn't get out of it, you know, and then I would just spiral out of like control where I'm just like in my head and I'm just losing the game in my head, right? And I started crying in the middle of a show in Glasgow. Once
delicious.
Just,
I like this.
Oh, it's just like, and I'm just, it's just like this sad sight, you know. I think There was
Is there a video of this?
I don't know, but it was just really bad. And
you
then
didn't, wait, I'm, you didn't want to go look and see if somebody had posted video of this online? No, I'm surprised.
No. This might have been before that was like a really common thing, yeah. But I've got a lot of them.
I guess people probably wouldn't see it though, right? Unless the camera was like,
oh yeah, yeah, yeah. No, it was just
It'd
bad.
I think be like, wow, he's really passionate.
Yeah,
he loves this song.
I remember like from what I'm told, I kind of blocked this out. We had a really great tour. I think it was 2007 or 8. With Panic at the Disco was the headliner, and then we were playing this whole tour, but I kind of blocked it out of my head. It was just a weird time for me, and I'd somehow like I'd grown my hair really long, and I had like this beard, and I think people at the label, because we were I think we were about to do My Dinosaur Life, and I remember they were referring to me as Fat Jesus. Yeah, it was like a really bad time. I was just in like, you know, I'd just gotten sober, and then I kind of just like gained a lot of weight and was like miserable. I don't know. It's a weird thing. So that whole thing happened. I once played a show in like early 2000s at this place called the Chicken Shack, which was somebody's house, where I was so drunk, I was singing in one at one speed and playing at another. So I wasn't. I don't
Amazing.
Remember.
Amazing.
That's what I'm told. And Josh at one time just pushed me away from the mic, and it was just a disaster.
Oh God.
Well, at least you didn't fall off the stage like Axl Rose. I don't know. People should look this up. Axl Rose falling off the stage is the most incredible thing, because it's like a 10-foot drop and he's just gone.
I have fallen off the stage, but it was more like I was
See,
rocking.
I was trying to set you up to say that.
Well, I was rocking and I wasn't drunk or anything. It was just like super rock, but a very small stage, small show.
Okay.
And then like I just
so that probably looked kind of cool, right?
I bounced into somebody and like and then I kind of fell off, but I kept playing, you know. I love that, like, who's it, Shirley from Garbage, that video is pretty rad, where she falls off the stage and just keeps going.
Yeah.
Love that.
Or the guy from Silverchair got hit in the head with a bottle and he kept going.
Yeah.
That's like, blood all over his face.
You know, this is, I don't know if people remember this, but Kelly Osbourne played music for a while, and I actually went to see...
You know her dad plays music.
Yeah, well, I went to...
No.
We were, who's her dad?
That is 100%
Kyle,
exact Galifianakis joke
God.
That I just totally stole.
Hold on, Kyle's skills have just disappeared.
I got, well, that's because I said a word. Got to concentrate.
I did. Anyway, this is a weird sidebar, yeah. But I did see her at a festival. You see like such strange. They have so much diverse, weird music at festivals. It doesn't make any sense. But I remember seeing that she was playing. I'm like, you know, I'm just gonna see what this is all about. And I think it was pretty terrible, but people were booing her and throwing like rocks and dirt at her.
Whoa,
and, like,
that's not cool.
But she like went through almost the entire set, and then she got hit in the head with like a rock. And was like, I'm sorry.
And she died?
No.
Oh.
But I still like, however horrible you think she and her music is or whatever, I still think that was pretty badass to continue.
That's tough as nails.
Yeah, that takes some guts. But yeah, so. What were we talking about?
Music.
Horrible shows.
But
I've played many.
Yeah, we're at the end of the episode here. Justin, thank you so much for being on the show.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for having me.
If you liked hearing from Justin, he was in an episode of Reiner and Phil from many years
ago. Way back when.
You can check that out.
I bought that game. It was Rage, and I ended up buying that and playing that. I liked it, but it was not as good as, like, you know, Bioshock meets Borderlands, but it still was a lot of fun.
Yep. I agree with you completely there. Good game, awesome tech, but something missing. Mm-hmm. But thanks for watching, everyone. Good job, Kyle, getting through a couple songs.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks to Wade Wojcik in the control room, and screw that Javy Gwaltney guy. We'll see you next time.
Justin, I really wanted to thank you for being here, because in your 2005 hit song, Everything Is All Right, you say you hate oceans, theme parks, airplanes, and talking with strangers. Mm-hmm. And we just met today, so I appreciate you doing that for me.
I appreciate you bringing this up. you're welcome, and go f*** yourself.